In LabVIEW 2013, installers have changed for the better. Let's take a look at this very simple acquire and analyze VI. We're doing a simple hardware timed DAC operation and doing some analysis on it. Obviously, the DACMX driver is being used. Now, I've built this into a project and already created an executable from it. Now, when it's time for me to build the installer, previously, I would walk through my categories over here on the left, put the executable in the folder I want, and then proceeding down the categories, I may choose a few other things, and I come to the Additional Installers tab. Now previously, before LabVIEW 2013, I'd need to look at all the potential drivers and runtime engines that could be included in my installer, and I'd have to know under the hood what my application is relying on, so that when it gets on this target computer, it doesn't break. Now we teach LabVIEW, and people always ask, well, why doesn't LabVIEW just know that? Well, now it does. As you can see, there's a checkbox, automatically select recommended installers. And we see what's been selected is NI LabVIEW Runtime Engine 2013 and NI DACMX Core Runtime 9.8. Now, since my application is using DACMX, that totally makes sense. If I were using some other type of driver, maybe NI Visa, it would be automatically included here as well. Now if I'd like, I can uncheck that and go as before and choose what I'd like to include. But this, far easier. Now you could justifiably ask, should I always just keep automatically select recommended installers checked? And the answer is possibly. But remember that if you do bundle in together these runtime engines and drivers, that your installer gets bigger. So if you know that your target computer, where the executable will be running, already has these runtime engines or drivers on it, then you wouldn't need to go and put them together in the installer. But if you don't know that, be safe and put them in there.